So that's what's so lovely about you is you have a childlike enthusiasm when it comes to your work. Do you remember? I know that we have a picture of you when you were a little little boy.
Oh, I know,
sweet. Look at that. You can see the inquisitive nature of that face.
Someone asked who saw that, said, are you playing with a video game there? No, this is like 1960. There is no video games. That's actually a train set that I was playing with.
But do you remember when the spark hit you, like you really, you found your path in life?
Yeah, I was nine, and the first visit to the Hayden Planetarium. Oh. And I'm a city kid, so you don't see the night sky. You have no relationship with the universe. So I go there, and you sit back, and the lights dim, the stars come out. I thought it was a hoax.
I know.
There aren't that many stars.
It's mind-blowing. Now the Rose Center for Science and Arts.
Yeah, thank you. It's like, I know there aren't that many stars because there's 14. I've seen them from the Bronx. You're lying to me. But it was a really beautiful lie, I thought. And later on, you'd see the actual sky. And to this day, it's a little weird, but I go to mountaintops, and I look up and I say, reminds me of the Hayden Planetarium.
Yeah.
It's like, to reference the universe to an urban thing is a little weird. But since then, from age 11 onward, if I had an answer to that annoying question that adults always ask kids, what do you want to be when you grow up? I said, I want to be an astrophysicist. That pretty much shut them up right there. They just, well, we got no comeback on that.
Okay. Well, good.